Debbie came all the way from Connecticut today. So thank you so much for being with us.
Comparing it to the reaction now as to what happened 9 years ago when my daughter took her life, which everybody's now talking about, and I think it's a good thing that everybody's talking about it, but here in the town I lived in, we had an actual suicide, and we had actual bullying going on, and real mental health issues to talk about, and nobody wanted to talk about it when it was right in their face and happened in their own school.
I decided that I wasn't going to watch it, and then I have to say I was drawn into it. I put the show on, and I'll never get that 13 hours of my life back. But I will say that one of the dangers of the show for me was that it was really well made and really well acted, but really poorly thought through. And hopefully we can have a little bit of conversation about that. You think about all the cases of shaming that go on with cyberbullying, and when we think about our role as parents and having raised three of them, it's terrifying to think that all the work that you do can be undone by something that you know nothing about.
Is that anything that I say, it's like, Mom, it's just your generation. They just think that way. Oh, you don't know what you're talking about. To understand that I was young at one point, and this was, no, this is not a new issue. It might be more talked about, but it's not new.
She was blogging on this website about whether she should do it or whether she shouldn't do it. And she's like, I'm 60% for it and I'm 40% against it. And there were 17 hits on this site. Nobody called us. Actually online with the former best friend the very morning that she did this. And they were just chit-chatting, like, in general, what are you going to do today? And the girl was, I'm going to play soccer. And I'm going to get my hair dyed. What are you going to do today? And she literally came out and said to her, I'm going to hang myself. And that girl wrote back, you know, your parents love you and you really shouldn't do that. And she tried to say the right things right into her, but did nothing beyond that.
And what the state of kids in the SOS program does this is that it is a strength, not a weakness, to seek help. And when any issue of safety is present, there is no confidentiality.
How does someone get help without having an unnecessary trail follow them? We're Alexa's friends. Did they ever come back to you and make their apologies?
But there were definitely absolutely difficult things that came out of 13 Reasons Why. If we could be hopeful about the positive things that have come about it, there's students that are talking about topics like suicide that may not have talked about it without seeing this. And we could dispel a lot of rumors and myth on that show, and I do think there's some, you know, serious damage that can be done by watching that in isolation, you know, students, kids on their iPad at bed at night with no dialogue with adults, and that really concerns me. But I have had probably 40 conversations with different students about this specific show, and they've been really wonderful conversations. So I think there's great things that can come as a result of something that wasn't maybe well done.
To be a parent, oftentimes you lose all of your pride, and all of your dignity, and I feel that happened a great deal, because my children, when they connected with me, would connect in sometimes horrible ways. They would tell me, you know, well, I'm not going to go into it, it's too embarrassing. But that, you know, I started by talking about connection, and that connection is really important. And one of the things that I realized was keep that connection and keeping asking those questions, despite what comes back at you, because it means something about your connection. And somebody said, you know, you said it earlier on about making connections with people and asking those questions, and people horrified that you asked the questions. How could you ask me that question? Well, you know that you planted a little seed, that you might get something back that's quite aggressive and mean, but if there is something there, then that is the beginning of a conversation.
This has been a wonderful program this evening. And it means so much to Debbie and I that you were having this discussion. We had strangers call us on the phone and say, "We're so sorry for your loss, and is there anything I can do for you?" So the community was extremely important in helping us heal. And you've honored Alexa's memory tonight by having this discussion. I thank you very much.
If you're interested in that article or these resources, we can have that. It would do us a huge favor if you went to the New Hampshire Conference, New Hampshire Conference of Churches Facebook page and gave it a like so that you can be part of ongoing conversations in the weeks and months to come. And thank you to Pastor John for moderating. You're not so bad.
Thank you again for coming. Thank you. Great. Come down and have a cookie.
Whenever you're ready.
I'm Lou George, the Transitional Executive Director for the New Hampshire Council of Churches, and we're very proud to have sponsored this event this evening on teen suicide, co-sponsoring actually with the Greater Concord Interfaith Council. We are committed to working with the churches and the various judicatories in the state of New Hampshire. We are committed to speaking out on issues that are current, issues that affect seriously the lives of the people of New Hampshire, that affect our churches, that affect our various judicatories, and affect our state. So we are appreciative of the attendance of those who came. We're very appreciative of the panel that brought such a rich thing for us tonight. And we appreciate the work of John and Knut in bringing this whole thing together. We hope that this is the first of several events, forums, panels, that we might have speaking to the issues of today. So thank you so much for being a part of this evening.